Okay, good afternoon to one and all. This is Gopi Krishna, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering from Chevrolet Engineering College. So, subject is compiler design. In previous class, we are going to discuss about introduction to intermediate code or free address code. So, here today we want to discuss about the forms of intermediate code. In previous class, we are discussing forms of intermediate code and what are the free address code representation. So the important topic in this one is free address code representation. In previous class, we are discussing about forms of intermediate code and introduction to unit 4. Okay, so here forms of intermediate code is here we are having three forms of intermediate code. So first one is the syntax tree or abstract syntax tree, and second one is the postfix notation, and third one is the free address code representation. So first one, syntax tree. Syntax tree means so it is a tree that consists of internal nodes or operators and leaf nodes or operands. What is an operand? It is like English alphabets, small a, and some values are operand. And what are the operators? So addition, multiplication, division, modulo division. So these are the some of the operators. So in this construction of syntax tree or abstract syntax tree, we are having intermediate nodes are operators and the leaf nodes are operands. Okay, that is the syntax tree. In previous class, we are going to discuss those concepts. And what is the postfix notation? So we want to convert one INFIX expression into postfix expression by using some rules. We have to convert an INFIX expression into postfix expression, right? So in that one, so we are having, so these are the forms of intermediate code. We can represent intermediate code in previous. First one is the syntax tree or abstract tree. Second one is postfix notation, and third one is the free address code representation. Okay, so in this syntax tree, in this internal nodes are operators and leaf nodes are operands. So here operands may be a variable or a constant. Okay, so in previous class we are discussing the forms of intermediate code. So in previous class we are discussing syntax tree or abstract syntax tree and postfix notation. So coming to free address code representation, so in this free address code representation, we want to represent, so we are following two conditions. What are the two conditions here? So in we are representing a instruction in a free address code representation, so we are having, it should contain at most three addresses or a three operands. Okay, so that is called the first condition. So what is the first condition? So in our instruction should contain at most three addresses or three operands. So that is the first condition. So at most means maximum three. So maximum three ante three kanna takkuva undochu, ekku matram undakoddu. So that is at most three operands. Okay, so that is the first condition. And next one, what is the second condition here? So in the right hand side, of your instruction, it should contain only one operator only. Okay, that is the condition. So we have to represent a instruction into free address code. Okay, is there any doubt with that 2 points? So we have to represent the free address code representation in one instruction. So in one instruction is going to represent in a free address code, we have to follow two conditions. So first one is the instruction should contain at most three addresses or three operands. Okay, and first one. Second one is the in that instruction we have right hand side. That right hand side should contain only one operator only. That is the second condition. So we have to follow these two rules. We have to represent a instruction into three address code representation. So in previous class we are discussing this this instruction. So we have to represent in three address code representation. Here A is equals to B star minus C plus B star minus c. So here minus c is the unary operator. So it having the highest precedence when compared to other operators. Okay. So in this 3 address 4 representation, so we are considering t1 as t1 is equals to minus c. So initially t1 is equals to minus c. Then t2 is equals to b star t1. T2 is equals to b star t1. So t2 is equals to b star t1. And so here one more minus c unary operator is available, so we have to consider t3 is equals to minus c, and t4 is equals to b star t3. So b star t3. Then finally t5 is equals to, so here total this one is considering as a temporary variable t2 plus this one is considering as a temporary variable t4. So t5 is equals to t2 plus t4. So this is one way to convert a instruction into 3 address 4. So here one more possibility is here. So that is t1 is equals to minus c. So let us consider t1 is equals to minus c. So this unary operator is considering as a one temporary variable. T1 is equals to minus c. Then t2 is equals to, again t2 is equals to b star t1. So t2 is equals to b star t1. So already we are having t1 is equals to minus c. There is no need to specify t3 is equals to minus 3. Then we are considering t3 is equals to, so we are using this one. So b star minus c is considering as t1. So b star t1. Then t4 is equals to, this total is considering as t2, and this one is considering as t3. So this is one more possibility. We have to convert a instruction into 3 address code. Okay, so that is the second possibility. So in these two possibilities we are considering any one. So we are having in this 3 address code representation. So after 3 address code representation, we have a code optimization at that situation. So this possibility is used for in future. So code optimization this use, so we can reduce the number of statements. So that is code optimization. So at that time we are using reducing instructions. Okay, so now we are considering this one as a 3 address code representation for the instruction a is equals to b star minus c plus b star minus c. So this is the given instruction. So this is the, we are converting this instruction into 3 address code representation. So after representing 3 address code representation, in this 3 address code we have three types of representation. So first one is the quadruple representation, and second one is the triple representation, and third one is the indirect triple representation. So these are the three ways to represent a 3 address code into quadruple and triple and indirect triple. So in previous class we are discussing we have to represent a 3 address code into quadruple representation. So we have to just recall that representation. So we have to represent this 3 address code in quadruple representation. So in quadruple representation, we are having four fields. So what is the four fields means? So first field is OP. OP means operator, and second field is argument 1, and third field is argument 2, and fourth field is result. So these are the four fields we are representing a 3 address code into quadruple representation. So here OP means operator, and second one is argument 1, third one is argument 2, and fourth one is result. So how to represent a 3 address code representation into quadruple representation? So here we are considering operator. So we are considering these are the 3 address code representation. So we are using this 3 address code representation. So t1 is equals to minus c. So here what is the operator? Here minus is the operator. So then place the minus. So here we are using 0 is the address for this row, and 1 is the address for this row, second, 2, 3, 4. So these are the addresses for for this rows. Okay, so here operator is minus, and what is the argument one? C is the argument one. And what is the argument two? Is there any argument two in this statement? In this three address code representation, there is no argument two. Then we have to empty that argument two. And what is the result here? T1 is the result. So we are placing T1 into result column. Okay, so that is the first instruction. Coming to second instruction, we are considering the address is 1. So what is the operator here? So here we are using the operator is star. Here using the operator is star, and we are placing star here. And what is the argument 1? So argument 1 is left side operand, argument 2 is right side operand. So here B is the argument 1, so B. And what is the argument 2? T1. Okay, what is the result here? T2. So that is placed in result column. And coming to next instruction, that is the address 2. So here minus, operator is minus, and what is the argument 1? C. And what is the argument 2? Is there any argument 2 is available? There is no argument 2 in third instruction. So we are placing empty. And what is the result here? T3. So we are placing T3 in this column. Okay, then considering fourth statement. So in this one, what is the operator here? Again, star. And what is the argument 1? B. And what is the argument 2? T3. And what is the result here? T4. And coming to next instruction. So we are considering that one as address 4. So here, what is the operator here? Plus is the operator. And what is the argument 1? T2. And what is the argument 2? T4. And what is the result here? T5. So this is the representation of we are generating three address code. That three address code into quadruple representation. So in this representation, so the main disadvantage of this quadruple representation, so we are using more number of temporary variables. Okay, more number of temporary variables. So we have to store those temporary variables. So it consuming a lot of memory in that symbol table. Okay, so symbol table lo temporary variables ekkuva ganaka manu store chesthe em avutundi, so the performance anedi decrease avutundi. So ante space anedi ekkuva occupy chestundi. So the main disadvantage of this quadruple representation, so is there in this representation we are having more number of temporary variables. So we have to store those temporary variables in the symbol table. It require more memory. So more memory ni kavalsi vastundi. So for example, manam ikkada teesukuna statement 5 instructions only. So in our program we have more than 50 instructions. We have more than 50 instructions. So we have to create temporary variables, temporary variables. So we need to store those temporary variables in quadruple representation. It having lots of memory to occupy those temporary variables in symbol table. So that is the main disadvantage of this quadruple representation. To overcome this quadruple representation, so to avoid the consuming of a lot of memory, so we are introducing the representation is a triple representation. Okay, so is there any doubt with this quadruple representation? Anyone? Anyone? Okay, next one. So we have to represent that three address code into triple representation. So what are the instructions here? We are having the instruction A is equals to B star minus C plus B star minus C. So first instruction is T1 is equals to minus C. Second instruction T2 is equals to B star T1. T3 is equals to minus C. T4 is equals to B star T3. T5 is equals to T2 plus T4. Okay, so these are the five instructions. So we have to represent these five three address code representation into triple representation to overcome the drawback in quadruple representation. So we are using triple representation. So we have to represent in triple representation. We are having three fields. So what is the first field? We are having the operator field, and second one is the argument one, and next one is the argument two. So what are the three fields here? We are having OP, operator, and second one is the argument one, and third one is the argument two. So these are the three fields. We have to construct a triple representation of a given three address code instruction. So we are having operator, argument one, argument two, argument one, argument, argument one, argument two. So here zero is the address for first instruction. So zero is the address for first instruction. So here operator is minus. Why? Because C1 is equal to minus C. So here operator is minus. And what is the argument one? C. C is the argument one. Okay. So what is argument two? There is no argument two in this first instruction. Okay. So in this triple representation, the field is result is not available in triple representation. Why? Because we have to overcome the drawback in quadruple representation. The drawback is, so we have to store the more number of temporary variables in that quadruple representation. So it need lots of memory. So to avoid those disadvantages, we are representing this triple representation. So the result is not, result field is not available in this triple representation. So in this first instruction, so address is zero and operator is minus, and C is the argument one. And what is the next second instruction? T2 is equals to B star T1. Okay. So what is the operator here? Star is the operator. And what is argument one? So B is the argument one. And what is the argument two? T1. So in this T1, we are storing T1 is equals to minus C, in that address is zero. So we are placing this zero here. Okay. So T1 is equals to minus C. So T2 is equals to B star T1. So B is the argument one, and star is the operator, and T1 is the argument two. So that T1 result is placed in the address is zero. So we are placing that address into argument two to avoid the representation of temporary variables in triple representation. Okay. Next. So what is the next instruction? T3 is equals to minus C. So what is the operator? Minus. And what is the argument one? C. There is no argument two. Next, what is the fourth instruction? T4 is equals to B star T3. So we are representing address is 0, 3. And so what is the operator here? Star. And what is the? B is the argument 1. So we are using B is the argument 1 field. And what is the T3 here? So T3 is equals to minus C. So that is placed in the address 2. So T3 is equals to minus C. That is placed in address 2. So we are representing in argument 2. So 2 is placed in argument 2 column. And next, what is the next instruction? Last instruction, T5 is equals to T2 plus T4. So what is the operator here? Plus is the operator. And so what is T2? So T2 is placed. So here T2 is placed in this column. So what is the address of T2? 1. And what is T4? T4 is placed in this address of 3. So we are placing argument 1 is address of 1, and argument 2 is address of 3. We are placing in the address of 4. So this is the representation of triple. We are in the given three address code instructions. Okay. Is there any doubt? The representation of triple. Is there any doubt? Boys, girls, No one? No doubt? So here in this,
no,
we are having three fields. First one is operator and second one is argument one. Third one is argument two. So this is the given instruction. We are converting this instruction into three address code representation. We have to convert a given instruction into three address code representation. We have to follow two rules. The first one is, so the instruction should contain at most three operands or three addresses, and that is the first condition. What is the second condition? In that instruction, right hand side, it should contain at most one operator only. So we are following that rules. We have to representing the given instruction to three address code representation. So in that three address code representation, we have to represent in triple representation. We are using operator and argument one, argument two. So we are using address 0, address 1, address 2, address 3, address 4 based on the number of instructions. So first instruction T1 is equal to minus C. So operator is minus and argument 1 is C. There is no argument 2. So here 1. Next T2 is equal to B star T1. What is the operator star and what is the argument 1? B. And what is the temporary variable? T1. So T1 is stored in address 0. So that is the reason why we are placing 0 in this column. Okay. So this is the representation of triple. So in this triple representation, the main advantage of this representation, temporary variables are not needed in this representation. So in this representation, is there any temporary variables in our table? There is no temporary variables in our table. So that is the main advantage of this triple representation. So the main advantage of this representation, temporary variables are not needed in this representation. So less amount of memory, we can execute the given instruction. So manu each instruction ni execute cheyadaniki manaki takku amount of memory anedi unte saripothundi ani ee representation lo cheptaru. So that is the main advantage of this triple representation. So what is the next representation? Indirect triple. What is the next representation? Indirect triple. So generally, indirect representation means we are using two tables. So first one is the triple table, and second one we are using to having addresses. So for example, we are having five instructions. So we are considering 0, 1, 2, 3 like that. So what is the indirect triple representation here? So the indirect triple representation, so in this representation, we need an extra table. The table contains pointers to the triple. So what is a pointer? So pointer stores the address of another variable. What is a pointer? A pointer stores the address of another variable. So that is called the pointer. So here we are using one more table that stores the address of pointers to the given triple table. So triple table edaithe undo aa triple table ki oka pointer ni create cheyadaniki ee indirect triple ni use chestaru. So in this representation, we need an extra table. That table contains pointers to the triple. Okay, so what is that table? So this is the table of triple, right? So instructions T1 is equal to minus C, T2 is equal to B star T1, T3 is equal to minus C, T4 is equal to B star T3, T5 is equal to T2 plus T4. Okay, so these are the given three address code representation. So these instructions that are representing in a triple representation, and we are using indirect triple. So we need an extra table. So that is the extra table. Here we are using the pointer address. So address of 0. 0 is the addresses, and 100 is the address of that particular location. So 101, 102, 103, 104. So we are using addresses. That means the pointers to the table. So what is a pointer? Pointer is a source the address of another variable. Okay. So that is the representation of indirect triple. So we are using pointers to the this particular triple table. Okay. So these are the triple table addresses. We are using some addresses pointers to the this particular triple. Okay. So this is the representation of indirect triple. Okay. Is it clear? Okay, so next one, the three address instruction forms. So ee three address instruction forms ela undayi. Okay, so three address instruction forms. So here, so first one is assignment instructions. Assignment instructions of the form x is equal to y operator z. So the production is the instruction is in the form of x is equals to y operator z. So ala unte danni kuda mana three address code forms lo cheptam. So three address instruction forms a form lo unte danni three address code lo undani cheptam. Okay, so general ga 2 points unnai, 2 points base cheskon cheppochu, lekapothe ee format lo unna kuda mana a particular values ni a particular instruction ni three address instruction forms ani cheptam. So first one is the assignment instructions of the form. Assignment means equal to, ante this total result is assigned to the variable x. Okay, so that is the assignment instruction. So assignment instructions of the form x is equal to y operator z, where operator is a binary operator, where operator is a binary operator. So what are the binary operators in our C language? In C language, so we are having binary operators are arithmetic operators, logical operators, relational operators, assignment and bit wise operator. So arithmetic means addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulo division. Logical operators means logical and, logical or logical not. So logical and double ampersand unde, logical and under double e unde, logical r antaru, double not ante, so logical not okati untundi. Assignment means equal and bitwise operator. So bitwise operators ante and r not, so ivatanni bitwise operators antaru. So those are called the binary operators in our languages. Okay, so assignment instructions of the form x is equals to y operator z, where op is a binary operator. So binary operators are arithmetic operators, logical operators, relational operators, assignment operators and bitwise operators. So ee form ela untundante x is equals to y operator z. So x is equals to y plus z ela undochu. So here plus is the arithmetic operator, x is equals to y greater than z. So relational operators ante enti, greater than, less than, greater than, less than, less than or equals to, greater than or equals to, double equals to and not equals to. So these are called the relational operators. So that is in the form of x is equals to y greater than z and x is equals to y ampersand, double ampersand, so logical and z. So x is equals to y double and z means logical and operator, and x is equals to y modulo division z. So modulo division means it is also an arithmetic operator. Okay, so three address instructions instruction forms is, so first one, assignment instructions are of the form x is equals to y op z. So ila unde vaatni assignment instructions ani cheptam. Okay, so this is the first one. So three address instruction forms lo first one, assignment instructions of the form. So next one, second, assignment of the form x is equals to opy. So opy, so x is a one variable and y is another variable, op is a operator. So here op is a unary operator, such as unary plus, unary minus and increment and decrement operators and logical not operators are called the unary operators. So assignments of the form x is equals to op y, where op is a unary operator such as unary plus, unary minus, increment, decrement, logical not. So what is the increment and decrement operator? So based on the position of a particular operator. So increment operators are two types and decrement operators are two types. So increment ante plus plus is the increment operator, minus minus is the decrement operator. the position of place of that particular increment operator. So before placing the operator, okay, that is a prefix increment, pre-increment and post-increment. Post-increment means after the operand we are placing the increment operator. So pre-increment, post-increment and pre-decrement and post-decrement. So those are the increment and decrement operators. So here we are using x is equals to op y. So where op is a unary operator. So unary means unary plus, unary minus, increment, decrement and logical not. So here is the example, x is equals to minus y. So x is a one variable and minus is the unary minus and y is another variable. So x is equals to plus plus y. So increment operator, pre-increment operator. So plus plus y. So increment and x is equals to not equals to y. So this is the logical not operator and x is equals to minus minus y. So it is a pre-decrement operator and we are using so assignment of the form allowed of the form x is equals to op y. So allowed na mano pre-instruction code ani cheppochu. Okay. So next one, third one, copy instructions of the form. Copy instructions of the form x is equals to y. So that means simply, so we are copy means we are having some value of y. That value is assigned to x only. That is clear. So copy instructions of the form x is equals to y, where the value of y is assigned to x. So and the y value ni x ki assign chestnam. That is the third one. Copy instructions of the form x is equals to y. Simply x equals to y. There is no operator here. Okay. So for example, y is equals to 20. Then we are having x is equals to y. So what is the value of x? 20. Okay. So this 20 is assigned to x. Y is equals to 3 and that 3 is assigned to x only. Okay. So that is the third one. Copy instructions of the form x is equals to y. So what is the next one? Unconditional jump. So go to L. For example, unconditional jump means, for example, there is no condition here. So then go to off that particular L. L means some value. Okay. So unconditional jump, go to off L. So go to off L means, so L is the some statements to be executed. So there is no condition. For example, we are writing a C program. Then in that C program we are writing go to off some function name. So add function. So go to add and put the direct add function kill according to statements execute this. There is no condition in that particular statement. So go to anedi general ga icheste a go to function anedi ekkadiki velthundi manam edaithe specify chesamo function name ఆ ఫంక్షన్ నేమ్ కి వెళ్ళి అక్కడ ఉన్న ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేస్తుంది. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద అన్కండిషనల్ జంప్. ఓకే, సో కండిషన్ ఏం లేదు, ఆ పర్టికులర్ లేబుల్కి వెళ్ళేసి ఆ లేబుల్లో ఉన్న స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ని ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేస్తుంది. సో ఈ రెల్ స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ లేబుల్. సో ఆ లేబుల్లో ఉన్న స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ని ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేస్తుంది. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద అన్కండిషనల్ జంప్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద నెక్స్ట్? కండిషనల్ జంప్. ఓకే, సో కండిషనల్ జంప్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫార్మ్ if x relop y go to L. So here relop means in compiler design we are using relop conditions that are relational operators. So what are the relational operators? Less than, greater than, less than or equals to, greater than or equals to, double equals to, not equals to. So these are called the relational operators. So simply we are writing relop, r-e-l-o-p. So x relop y go to L. So if this condition we are using, so conditional jumps of the form if x relop y means go to L. So if this condition is true, then go to this label only. That's it. Okay, so ee condition ganaka true ayindi ante, so ee label lo unna statements ni execute cheyamani. So ee condition false aithe there is no need to go to label. Okay, so that is the first one. And conditional jumps of the form if x go to L1, else go to L2. So for example, ఇది ఎలా ఉంటుందంటే కండిషనల్ జంప్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫామ్ ఇఫ్ ఎక్స్, ఇది ఎక్స్ అంటే ఒక పర్టికులర్ ఇచ్చామనుకోండి ఒక ప్రోగ్రాంలో గో టు ఇచ్చేసి ఆ గో టు దగ్గరికి వెళ్తే ఆ గో టు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అయితే ఈ లేబుల్లో ఉన్న స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వాలి. ఓకే, అది కాకుండా లేకపోతే లేబుల్ టూలో ఉన్న స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ కావాలి అని రాస్తే సరిపోతుంది. ఓకే, ఇఫ్ ఎక్స్ గో టు ఎల్ వన్ ఎల్స్ గో టు ఎల్ టూ, సో ఇఫ్ ఎక్స్ గో టు ఎల్ వన్ ఎల్స్ గో టు ఎల్ టూ. ఓకే, సో దిస్ మీన్స్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ కండిషనల్ జంప్స్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇఫ్ రీలోప్ కండిషన్ ఎక్స్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ వై, ఇఫ్ దిస్ కండిషన్ ఈజ్ ట్రూ దెన్ గో టు లేబుల్, సో ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ ద దిస్ లేబుల్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్. సో హియర్ ఇఫ్ ఎక్స్ గో, అది ఆ కండిషన్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ అక్కడ ఒక వాల్యూ అనేది ఎక్స్ కి 10 ఇచ్చా అనుకోండి, ఎల్ వన్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వాలి లేకపోతే ఎల్ టూ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వాలి అని చెప్తాం. సో ఇఫ్ ఎక్స్ అనేది ఫర్ నంబర్ అవ్వచ్చు, సమ్ వేరియబుల్ అవ్వచ్చు, ఏదైతే అంటే ఎక్స్ అది అయితే ఎల్ ఎల్ వన్లో ఉన్న స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వాలి, అది కాకపోతే ఎల్ స్టేట్మెంట్లో ఉన్న ఎల్ టూలో ఉన్నాయి ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వాలి. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద కండిషన్ 5. సో కండిషనల్ జంప్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫామ్ అండ్ కండిషనల్ జంప్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫామ్ దిస్ వన్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద 3 అడ్రస్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఫార్మ్స్. అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్? 6th వన్. సో హియర్ 6th వన్ ప్రొసీజర్ కాల్స్ అండ్ రిటర్న్స్ ఆర్ ఇంప్లిమెంటింగ్ యూజింగ్ ద ఇంప్లిమెంటేషన్ యూజింగ్ ఫాలోయింగ్. సో ప్రొసీజర్ కాల్స్, ప్రొసీజర్ కాల్స్ అంటే ఏంటి? సమ్ ఫంక్షన్ కాల్స్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఫంక్షన్స్ ఉన్నాయి, యాడ్ ఎడిషన్ ఫంక్షన్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్, సో ఏడిడి ఆఫ్ అండ్ ఎంయుఎల్ ఆఫ్, సో ఎస్యుబి సబ్స్ట్రాక్షన్, సో ఎస్యుబి ఆఫ్, సో అలాంటి వాటిని ఫంక్షన్ కాల్స్ అంటారు. సో అవి వచ్చినప్పుడు అలాంటివి ఉన్నా కూడా మనం దాన్ని 3 అడ్రస్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఫామ్ అంటారు. అలా కాకుండా అండ్ రిటర్న్స్ ఆర్ ఇంప్లిమెంటేషన్ యూజింగ్ ద ఫాలోయింగ్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సమ్ పారామీటర్, సో ఒక పారామీటర్ ఎక్స్ తీసుకున్నారు, ఓకే దెన్ వై ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు కాల్ పి, సో ఈ కాల్ పి మీన్స్ పారామీటర్ దెన్ ఎన్, సో వై ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు కాల్ దట్ పారామీటర్ అండ్ సో ఎన్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ పారామీటర్స్ ఉన్నాయి రిటర్న్ వై, సో వై ని రిటర్న్ చేయాలి. సో దిస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వన్. సో సో ఫంక్షన్ ప్రొసీజర్ కాల్స్ అండ్ రిటర్న్స్ ఆర్ ఇంప్లిమెంటింగ్ యూజింగ్ ద ఫాలోయింగ్. ఓకే, సో దిస్ ఇస్ 6th వన్. అండ్ 7th వన్ అడ్రసెస్ అండ్ పాయింటర్ అసైన్మెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫామ్. సో ఇలా ఉన్నా కూడా వాటిని 3 అడ్రస్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ అని చెప్తాము. సో అలా ఏంటి అంటే అడ్రసెస్ అండ్ పాయింటర్ అసైన్మెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫామ్. సో అడ్రస్ ఆపరేటర్, సో అడ్రసెస్ అంటే ఒక ఆపరేటర్ అంటే బై యూజింగ్ పాయింటర్స్, సో ఎక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు వై అంబర్సెంట్ వై మీన్స్, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏ అడ్రస్ ఆపరేటర్. ఓకే, సో ఎక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు అంబర్సెంట్ వై మీన్స్ ద అడ్రస్ ఆఫ్ వై విల్ బి స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ వేరియబుల్ ఎక్స్, దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ అడ్రసెస్. ఓకే, అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ పాయింటర్ అసైన్మెంట్ మీన్స్, సో ఎక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు స్టార్ వై తీసుకున్నారు అనుకోండి, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏ డి రిఫరెన్స్ ఆపరేటర్. సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ స్టార్ 1000, సో దిస్ ఈజ్ సమ్ అడ్రస్, సో వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ దిస్ వన్ స్టార్ 1000 మీన్స్ ఈ 1000లో ఉన్న మెమరీలో ఈ 1000 అడ్రస్లో ఉన్న వాల్యూని ప్రింట్ చేస్తుంది. సో ఈ స్టేట్మెంట్ అది ఎక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు స్టార్ వై, సో స్టార్ వై మీన్స్ వైలో ఒక అడ్రస్ ఉంటుంది, ఆ అడ్రస్లో ఏ వాల్యూ అయితే ఉందో ఆ వాల్యూని ఎక్స్కి అసైన్ చేస్తుంది. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద అడ్రసెస్ అండ్ పాయింటర్ అసైన్మెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫామ్. ఓకే, ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్? ఎక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు అంబర్సెంట్ వై మీన్స్ అడ్రస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ వేరియబుల్ కెన్ బి స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ వాల్యూ ఎక్స్ అండ్ పాయింటర్ డి రిఫరెన్స్ ఆపరేటర్. డి రిఫరెన్స్ ఆపరేటర్ అంటే ఈ వై దగ్గర ఏదైతే అడ్రస్ ఉందో ఆ అడ్రస్లో ఉన్న వాల్యూని ప్రింట్ చేస్తుంది, సో ఆ వాల్యూని ఎక్స్కి అసైన్ చేస్తుంది అని చెప్తారు. ఓకే, సో ఇట్లా స్టార్ 1000, సో ఈ 1000 అనేది వై అనుకోండి, వై యొక్క అడ్రస్ అనుకోండి, సో ఈ 1000లో ఉన్న వాల్యూ 20 అనేది ఈ 20 దట్ ఈస్ అసైన్ టు ఎక్స్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద అడ్రసెస్ అండ్ పాయింటర్ అసైన్మెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫామ్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఇండెక్స్డ్ copy instructions of the form. So indexed means, for example, we are using some arrays. Arrays use chesinappudu ela use chestaru? So array ante enti? So which is having similar data items under one common name. So a of i is equal to somewhere a of i ala represent cheste danni array representation and so alanti vaadni manam represent chey so indexed copy instruction so so y of I and this nanko I is equals to 10 iskunte so y ki 10 values untai y is equals to 0 1 2 3 atla oka 10 values isthunnanko those 10 values can be assigned to small x so that is the indexed copy instructions of the form so these are the seven types so three address instruction forms so ee seven types lo e rakamga unna kuda vaatni three address code instruction ane cheptam so ee forms lo ela ee forms ee seven forms lo ela unna kuda danni three address code lo unnai ane cheptam so manam convert chesedappudu aina so we are converting a instruction into three address code so we are using these seven types of forms okay so these are the seven types is there any doubt boys is there any doubt anyone respond hello
sir
anyone any doubt
No, sir.